Children, in the previous session, we studied about the process of image formation by the concave mirror. The image formation of convex mirror we will be studying in online class. So next we shall look at the uses of concave mirror and convex mirror. This is also very important. You might be already knowing the uses, but still we shall recall it once. By drawing so many the ray diagrams and all, you should be in a position to say where it is used. So, concave mirrors are mainly used in torches and in searchlights, in headlight of the vehicles, where we need high beam of light, children. High beam of light is required. So, it is used in torchlights, street searchlights, headlights of vehicles, mainly by the dentist and as well in solar furnace. Why do you think the dentists use? It is because, when they place the mirror inside of a mouth nearby the teeth, the image should look enlarged. Yes, no? The image should look enlarged. That is the purpose they use it, so that they can view the enlarged image of the teeth. So that is the uses of concave mirror. Where convex mirror uses, main use of convex mirror under the children, in rear view mirrors of the vehicles. I have already said you many times, the big lorry or the bus or the truck appears so small, diminished image will be formed, which is capturing in the small mirror. So that is the main purpose, where that is the work done by the convex mirror. So convex mirror main use enondre, it is used in the rear view mirrors of the vehicles. They may ask you which type of mirror used in rear view mirror of vehicles andre, you should say it is convex mirror, that is the divergent mirror, children. Apart from that, it is used in the sunglasses allo use maartare, and magnifying glasses alli, and what else, street lights, street light reflectors. You can see as many uses you want about the concave mirror and the convex mirror. After learning about this uses, you have one small topic, that is about the sign convention of the mirrors. What is this sign convention, Andhra children? We already know or learned this table. We know the basic ray diagram, isn't it? Now, based on that ray diagram, there are certain rules to be followed when you solve the problems. So, after learning about the ray diagrams of the image formed by the concave mirror at different positions and all, now we should be able to solve the problems based on them. For that sake, we should know about this sign convention, S-I-G-N, sign convention. That is, some rules need to be followed. Now, you know the basic diagram, that only I will draw. Concave mirror. This applies both to concave mirror, convex mirror. In further classes, we will be studying about this lens as well, children. This will be applied to lens also. So, understand it clearly here itself, so that it will be helpful for you in further classes. Shade maadde, I will label MN, what I should draw. I should draw the principal axis, pole, F, principal focus, center of curvature. This is the skeleton of the ray diagram, we all know. These sign conventions, you basically have 4-5 points, children, which are there. First point, for this you should know about the size of the image formed. Hint realva, real, inverted, AB is used to represent object, A dash, B dash for image, arrowhead, adala ili apply on the picture. So, first point what we should say is, we know this line is principal axis and this is the pole of the mirror. Now, you learnt what is radius of curvature and what is focal length. What it is, the distance from pole to center of the curvature of the mirror is R. Distance PC is equal to R, and we studied PC is equal to R, that is radius of curvature. Similarly, distance from pole to the principal focus of the mirror PF is F, that is focal length of the both picture. Why are we measuring all the distances from P to C, P to F? It is one of the rule under sign convention, children. All the distances may be distance from to the principal focus ah athwa distance to the center of curvature ah you'll need object it from distance from pole to center of to the object ah to the image ah whatever distance you are measuring it should always be measured starting from the pole of the mirror that is the first point under sign convention you know all the distances should be measured starting from the pole of the mirror second point states that all the distances measured which towards the left hand side are taken as negative and all the distances measured towards right hand side are taken as positive this is very important especially while solving the problem children sign conventions we need to apply in order to solve the numericals keep this in mind all the distances are measured starting from the pole of the mirror all the distances which are measured towards left hand side are taken as negative towards right hand side are taken as positive that is second point third point all the heights ನಮಗೆ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬರಿಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಬರಿತೀವಿ ಎ ಬಿ ಅಂತ ಬರಿತೀವಲ್ವಾ ಸೊ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ನ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇನ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೀಚ್ ಯು ಹೌ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಹೈಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಹೈಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ All the heights measured above principal axis are taken as positive. All the heights measured below principal axis are taken as negative. That is third point. Next point is children. And you saw me draw 6 ray diagrams totally for image formation by concave mirror. In all the 6 ray diagrams, children, we kept the object towards the left side of the mirror. Have you ever seen the object placed here? No. In one of the case, the image was found behind the mirror. But in all the cases, we used to place the objects towards the left hand side of the mirror. So that is one condition of the sign convention. Always the objects are placed on the left hand side of the mirror so that the light from the source is always coming from left hand side. ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನಾವು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡ್ತಿರೋ ಅದೇ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಲೈಟ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸೋ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಸಾರಿ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿರರ್ ಅಂತ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ 5 ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ 5-4 ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇನ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಕೆಳಗ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಚಿಲ್ರ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ 2 ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೈನ್ ಕನ್ವೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಜರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿರರ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಿರರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ The distance towards the left hand side are taken as negative and all the distances towards right hand side are taken as positive. Fourth point is all the heights measured above the principal axis is taken as positive. Fifth point is all the heights measured below the principal axis is taken as negative. These are the 5 main points you will have to recall or remember in order to solve the problem. This is about sign convention, children. Next session we shall be learning about the mirror formula which is very important once we are learning the formula of course we should get ready to solve the problem my dears so it is very easy don't worry problems are very easy I will be teaching you and again one problem compulsorily you will be getting maybe on mirror or on the lens so till now what have we studied we started with what is light properties of light what is reflection of light And we studied the process of reflection of light with respect to plane mirrors. What are spherical mirrors we studied? Why are they called spherical mirrors? And those would be types of spherical, that is convex and concave mirror. Those would be concave convex mirrors. Only how the process of reflection take place we studied. Next we studied about the image formation by concave mirror and various terms or parts of the mirrors like pole, center of curvature, radius of curvature. All that we studied. And in the last session we studied about various ray diagrams and mainly the table where we studied the image formation by concave mirror
image formation by convex mirror I am explaining in online class, and different uses of concave and convex mirror we studied, and finally the sign convention we have studied. Every point and everything is very very important, children. So please read the textbook and keep yourself ready. Next class we shall be learning the mirror formula and as well solve some problems based on that. It is again very easy. Till then, thank you, children.